Okay, good morning, everybody. May butag. Okay, so welcome to the press conference of the National Anti-Poverty Commission. We have with us in our panel, we have the secretary, of course, and the lead convener of NAPC. We have Attorney Noel Felongco.
Yes, ma'am. Good morning.
Good morning. Well, and of course, we have together with him is the head of the research unit of NAPC, Mr. Fernando. Okay, so to start our press conference, we'd like to ask our panelists, our guests here, to give a little bit of a background, perhaps about NAPC, and then later on, what is this program that they have for us. Let's start with Attorney.
Yes, good morning. Thank you, John. Magandang umaga po sa lahat. First of all, I'd like to give my thanks to everyone for coming over in just a short notice. Full force po kayo, ang media po ng Cagayan de Oro City. Maraming salamat po sa inyo. So just to situate everyone, let me talk about briefly on NAPC, the National Anti-Poverty Commission. It's an agency established by RA 8425, and it is an agency that aims to ensure the continuity of social reform that addresses the basic inequalities in the Philippine society and has the following mandates. Number one, to act as the coordinating and advisory body that exercises oversight functions in implementing the SRA and ensure that it's incorporated in the formulation of national, regional, sub-regional, and local development plans. Second, to institutionalize basic sector and NGO participation in the management of social reform agenda cycle and in the decision-making process of our government. Third, to help and strengthen LGUs so that they can incorporate the social reform agenda in their local development efforts. So, under the government of President Rodrigo Duterte, NAPC is involved in the overall government plans to really lower down the poverty incidence of the country from 21.6% to 14%, and that the target should be achieved at the end of the term of President Rodrigo Duterte. So if we translate that percentage into real numbers, we are hoping that by 2022, 6 million to 8 million Filipino will be lifted out from poverty. And in addition to that, the president has also given us his vision for the country that by 2040, poverty will be a thing of the past in the country. Meaning, by 2040, the Philippines will attain zero poverty. That all Filipinos will have comfortable life and nobody will be left behind with our economic growth in the country. So that's the vision of our president. By 2040, Philippines will be transformed into a prosperous middle-class society. So there will be no poor people in the Philippines by 2040. And we are guided by that vision. The office enjoins to revitalize the partnership between the national government and the 14 basic sectors. The setup here in NAPC is very unique. Unique in a sense that you cannot find the organizational setup in other line agencies and in even in the local government units, where the 14 basic sectors are really embedded in the structure and they are actually active in the decision-making processes of the agency. So, who are these the 14 basic sectors? Let me enumerate the sectors. The farmers and landless rural workers, artisanal and landless rural workers, urban poor, indigenous peoples, formal labor and migrant workers, workers in the informal sector, women, children, youth and students, senior citizens, persons with disabilities, victims of disasters and calamities, non-government organizations, and cooperatives. As I said earlier on, these 14 basic sectors are important organs or are important in the organizational structure of NAPC. They are our partners and they really actively participate in the decision-making processes of NAPC. So NAPC explored and got into partnership with the different government agencies in order to uplift the lives of the poor by providing quality social services to all stakeholders. A couple of poverty alleviation partnership programs of NAPC are as follows. Number one, the establishment and operation of around 725 community fish landing centers. This project is in collaboration with BIPAR that aims to spur inclusive growth in coastal areas with high poverty incidence and large population of registered fisherfolk. Second is the Sagana at Ligtas na Tubig para sa Lahat or Saling Tubig. This project is in collaboration with the Department of Interior and Local Government and Department of Health to provide water supply systems for the 455 waterless municipalities, waterless barangays, waterless health centers, and waterless resettlement sites, and enhance the capacity of the LGU and water service providers in the planning, implementation, and operation of water supply facilities. And as our quest to address poverty continues, NAPC comes up with 3 banner programs under my watch. First is the Sambayanihan Servisyong Sambayanan, or we call it SSS. This program will answer the need to alleviate and reduce poverty and is based on developing rural and urban agriculture and industry as the most important preconditions for overcoming extreme poverty. It consists of the following basic components. Number one, providing the informal settler families and the urban poor with basic services and access to climate responsive dwelling, livelihood, and employment. Second, developing innovative infrastructure and financing mechanisms to the rural poor. Third, strengthening rural urban agro-economic value chains. Fourth, securing the health and general well-being of poor communities. Fifth, enhancing food security. And lastly, Mindanao Special Development Program. Now, in order for this sambayanihan, serbisyo sa bayanan to be felt by our people on the ground, we have devised some mechanisms. And one of these mechanisms is our plan to roll out the Provincial Consultative Body or PCB. This is a convergent consultative mechanism at the provincial level that serves as an avenue for collaboration and coordination between government agencies, primarily the local government units and the communities, as well as mainstream the participation of people and civil society organizations in recommending, implementing, and monitoring anti-poverty programs and services. Lastly, is our ADAPT 40-10-10, which is the actionable development agenda for poverty transformation. This intends to help poor communities across the country adapt to the effects of climate change. 40-10-10 denotes a list of 40 provinces based primarily on poverty incidence, from which the 10 poorest municipalities per province and the 10 poorest barangays per municipality will be selected. This amounts to a total of 4,000 barangays nationwide, which will serve as ADAPT 40-10-10 target areas over the plan period. All other areas will be considered as service areas of the NAPC. Later on, as we go on with our press con, my colleague here, Mr. Fernando Cao, the head of our research and operation team, will discuss this 40-10-10, the 40 provinces, 10 municipalities, and 10 barangays. So, with this, I am now open to questions. Thank you so much. Good morning.
Okay, thank you, Attorney. Our first question will come from Arcel Amade.
Thank you, John. By the way, I'm Arcel Bandig of PNA and Business Week Mindanao. Sir, the poorest province in the country is Lanao del Sur, in which belong to the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region. Now, do you have any specific and special program for poverty alleviation on that area? Since we still tackling the basic the Bangsamoro Organic Law on the second phase.
Actually, NAPC welcomes the ratification of the Basic Organic Law. We have seen and we were informed that most of the areas of the former Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao ratified the law establishing this Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao. And I'm also happy to know that my hometown, Cotabato City, has joined the Autonomous Region. For NAPC, we are willing to help the leadership of the BARM in really achieving poverty reduction or in uplifting the poor people inside the Bangsamoro area. One plan is to help our farmers in the ARM area or BARM area. You know, in Mindanao, the poverty incidence is 40%. If you listened earlier on, I informed you that the poverty incidence nationwide is 21.6%. So if the poverty incidence in Mindanao is 40%, so it is higher than the national poverty incidence. So the situation, the percentage, you know, shows the real situation here in Mindanao. And for your information, the 40% of poverty incidence, most of the areas are coming from the Bangsamoro area. You said it right, sir, that Lanao del Sur is the number one province where we can find many poor people. The poverty incidence there is, if I'm not mistaken, it's 76%. So we need really to help our farmers in the Bangsamoro area, particularly in Lanao del Sur. In fact, I have talked to some of our farmer friends in Lanao del Sur, and they are willing to collaborate with NAPC. In fact, what they are telling us is we asked the MILF, which is actually the leading force to lead the new ARMM, to advocate to the farmers the so-called organic farming. No? Because we believe that organic farming will truly help our farmers. The problem right now of our farmers is basically the high cost of inputs in producing rice. These inputs are the synthetic fertilizer, the pesticides, herbicides, and even the seeds. So the cost of acquiring these requirements in order for you to produce rice or palay is very much high compared to the yield. The yield is so low that we can say that farming actually in the Philippines is not profitable. That's why we have a lot of children of farmers who are not anymore engaging into farming. No? Just like, for example, yours truly. I am a son of a farmer in South Cotabato, but I already left my community in Norala, South Cotabato, because we have seen that farming is not really lucrative, and you know, it's a profession for the poor people, so it's not profitable. So we better find a place outside of the farming communities in order to make our lives better. So that's the problem right now of our farmers. So top of the agenda of NAPC is really to help our farmers and to advocate to them to shift from this kind of farming to organic farming. Now, because organic farming will not only help our farmers gain more income, but it will also help our environment. Now, because organic fertilizer will bring back the nutrients lost because of the use of synthetic fertilizers, and even organic fertilizer will prevent more pests, no, to destroy or to damage the palay, because organic farming will make these insects not palatable for them to eat the the palay. No? So you will really make a situation wherein the farmers will not anymore have the problem on the high cost, but the result of doing organic farming is to have high yields. Imagine, it's not anymore an imagination, meaning organic farming has been tested in some areas in the Philippines. Just for example, in Tago, Surigao del Sur, we have tested the use of organic fertilizer before. They are using synthetic fertilizer and the yield is only 40 to 60 cabans per hectare. But the moment they use the organic fertilizer, the minimum yield per hectare is 100 sacks. So far, the farmers there were successful to get 117 sacks per hectare. So that will really help a lot for our farmers to have more income in their production of palay. So that's our number one plan to help our farmers by encouraging them to do organic farming.
Okay, sir, do you have any target figures as of amount in alleviating this 40-10-10 LGUs?
Yes, I will give the microphone to Mr. Ferdinand Cao for him to discuss the these numbers and the plan of NAPC.
And then to add on my query, how you target the vision of the president for poverty alleviation 2022, 6.8 million will be lighted out to poverty, it's viable. Yes. But 2040, Philippines will attain zero poverty. So I don't think so it's achievable, considering that 2040 is not the administration of President Duterte already.
I agree with you that the 2040 vision is already beyond the presidency of President Rodrigo Duterte. But what is good here is the vision. Vision to for all Filipinos. No? And we actually are praying that this vision will be adopted by the next administration. Okay? So if there will be continuity in all the programs of the government, I truly believe it's not impossible to reach that vision that by 2040, there will be no poor people in the Philippines. So that's a vision that our president would like all Filipinos to adopt and to think about. No? Kung nagkakaisa tayo sa ganyang vision, I think walang imposible. Ang importante niyan, nagkakaroon tayo ng iisang goal at sabay-sabay tayong pupunta doon sa goal. Yun yung kailangan i-develop natin sa ating mga mindset ngayon, no? So unity is very important here. Kaya nga kung napansin niyo doon sa aming banner program, the title is Sambayanihan. Sambayanihan is bayanihan. Actually, we would like to bring back the spirit of bayanihan among Filipinos. Diba? So yun po, magiging positive lang po tayo. At alam nyo, pag positive tayo, even in our individual life, di ba? Everything will be in accordance with, sabi nga natin, positibong pananaw. Maganda po yung darating at pag ganyan lang ang lahat ng Pilipino, sabay-sabay tayo, may positive na pananaw, tsako uunlad ang ating bansa.
And now about if the next administration,
the next administration is an opposition of this administration, did you think that they will adopt the vision of the Duterte administration?
You know, itong vision na to ay sinimulan ng ating Presidente Rodrigo Duterte. At kapag ang lahat ng Pilipino ay aakuin itong vision na to, yung isang pangarap, no? Yung dream, ay tingin ko kahit opposition pa nga ang mananalo sa sunod na administrasyon, hindi niya kayang alisin yung ganyang panaginip o dream or yung vision na yan sa lahat ng mga Pilipino. Di ba? Sabi ko nga kanina, kapag nagkaisa tayong lahat na merong ganyang vision, no? Kahit opposition yan, baka sasama sa ganyang vision. At tuloy-tuloy po yung mangyayari sa ating bansang Pilipinas. Yan ang kailangan natin ngayon, na ituloy-tuloy yung mga magagandang pangarap ng ating taong bayan para sa kanilang sarili, kanilang pamilya, sa komunidad, at sa buong bansa. So yun po, sir. Very positive po ako na kahit opposition yan, pero napakaganda ng pangarap na ito, kanila pong tatanggapin yung ganyang pangarap na yan.
Okay, thank you, Attorney. Now we go to Sir Fernando. Oh, before we give another question. Yes po.
Magandang umaga po. Ano? Gusto ko lang pong i-follow up yung naging sagot ni Secretary Noel. No? Let me point out that what we in NAPC are doing now under the guidance of, under the leadership of Secretary Noel and under the guidance of President Duterte, what we are trying to do is to break the cycle of poverty in the country. Okay? Now, we will break the cycle of poverty by attacking the systemic causes of poverty. Karamihan po ng causes of poverty are structural and systemic in nature. And thus, our programs will attempt to break up strategically or change steps. Now, doon po sa mga nabanggit ni Secretary Felongco kanina, yung anim na components ng sambayanihan, which included creating value chains or reinforcing or strengthening the rural-urban connection, saka yung pong Mindanao Special Development Program. These are not palliative measures. These are open frontal declarations or attacks against the systemic nature of poverty in the country. So, kumbaga po, ang analogy po dito is, this time around, NAPC will not do business as usual programs. Okay? We will break the cycle, so much so that after breaking the cycle of this systemic poverty in the countryside and in the urban areas, we open the door for the attainment of the 2040 vision of zero poverty. We have to start somewhere, and we are starting now. Okay? Now, the figures before you are targets, of course, no? parang pangarap or grand visions, but if we don't do this, if we don't attempt to achieve this, then we will forever be inside that vicious cycle. In 2019, this year, we envision this to be the social preparation states, or what we call as the SOC prep. The SOC prep states includes various activities like coordination with the various agencies of government, from the national agencies down to the level of the local government units. It would also involve coordination with civil society organizations, people's organizations, and other private groups. Okay? The SOC prep states also includes prototyping. Okay? We will test, we will formulate programs and make prototypes of them for deployment later on. Okay? Now, after the SOC prep states, we will implement these programs, these poverty alleviation and reduction programs to certain areas. We will identify target areas according to the poverty incidence maps that we have created. The goal after 1 year of deployment is to lift out of poverty 500,000 Filipinos. Okay? Now, during the implementation of the program, we will conduct initial evaluation and impact assessment. And after conducting this this assessment and evaluation, as we deploy to other areas, okay, we will customize these programs according to the situation on the ground. And by year 2021, our goal is to lift out 1 million Filipinos from poverty. By 2022, the goal is 1.5, and by 2023, the goal is 3 million. These figures are minimum, okay? It could be more, and we will definitely work for more, okay? Now, you may notice that by 2023, it's no longer the term, or it's beyond the term of President Rodrigo Duterte. Just like what Secretary Noel is saying, if we are effective in deploying our anti-poverty programs, we don't think any politician would reverse what has already been achieved. Okay? So we are banking on our effectivity in the coming years so that our audience will no longer be the political parties or the politicians, national and local. Our audience will be the people themselves. And once you get the buy-in of the poor people themselves, I don't think it would be possible to reverse their situation any longer. Remember, as Secretary Noel said, what we will deploy generally here is the concept of bayanihan. Okay? Bayanihan is the ancient Filipino spirit of collective action and cooperation. It is normally portrayed as a group of men carrying a house from one place to another. But it is beyond that. Bayanihan has been with our ancestors from time immemorial, from planting to harvest season, and bayanihan have animated their lives 24/7 every day of the year. That spirit is what we seek to foster, rekindle, and revive. Yung pong pagiging Pilipino, yung pong mga matatanda nating kaugalian, yung po ang nakikita namin siyang magbibikis-bikis sa atin sa ambisyong ito na forever mawala ang poverty sa bayan natin. Yun lang po.
Okay, thank you po, sir. And our next question, please leave your nature and the audio.
Okay, good morning, Secretary Noel Felongco. Alan Claves, Program Director sa Radyo Medina, an affiliate station sa PBS Radyo Filipinas. This is particularly sir sa province of Misamis Oriental, kaya we are live now. Concerning later on, mayroon kayong memorandum signing with the PFAR, particularly with the Fraser Folk. Sir, sayo na lang ako pang masamtan sa mga usaging kapapinaw. Ano na ba ang nakatutok na usang katul o mekanismo para ma-insure na kaning proyekto sa gobyerno, labi na sa mga Fraser Folk? Like for example, ibang saysay, the construction of a community fish landing by the PFAR na until now hindi naka-function. Because of the social preparations na needed, nabatay, nabaiwansan tool or mekanismo ang NAPC para ma-insure sa NGO na ma-implemented ang anti-poverty program.
Yeah. Mayon ang pangutana, no? Kanang about sa Fisher Fox, kunya doon natay memorandum of agreement signing sa BIPAR National Director. O katang kanang MOA nagamando sa NAPC o sa BIPAR na paglingunon ang relasyon o ang working activities para matagaan o maayong serbisyo ang atong mga mangingisda. One of the projects of BIPAR is the construction of the community fish landing centers. Og gitahasan ang NAPC diha nga ma-involve para sa paghimo og social preparation. Doon na may mga gipangtuboy o gipang-appoint ng mga community organizers, no? Sa Mindanao, sa Visayas o sa Luzon. Ang usara gyud ka dakong problema namo nga makita is ang pondo, no? O ang support sa local government units. Kung ang LGU doon ay support sa atong mga ngisda o support sa community fish landing centers, kana nga proyekto magpadayon o mulambo. Apan kung ang LGU magbabaya, wag yun mahitabo. Mauna nga, in our engagements with the local government units, among yung unahon, istoryahon ang mayor, ang vice mayor, o ang members of the sangguniang, na suportahan nila kining mga community peace landing centers. Through, kung kaya, dunay SB resolutions, no, or ordinance. Dili lang suportahan sa kanang pag-istorya, kundi suportahan po sa pondo, no? Kay kinahanglan man after ma-turnover ang mga centers, para magpadayon, doon ay continuing appropriation po ng ihatag ang taga-LGU. We were successful in many LGUs. Mana nga, doon na yung mga nag-operate ng mga landing centers karon o nakabinipisyo na nga itong mga mangingisda. Apan, doon na po at uban nga among na-monitor nga nahimong white elephant, no? Kay wala yun na suportahan sa ato mga LGUs. So, we are working on it na itong mga white elephants ng mga peace landing center, no? i-operate na gyud og among gyud pangayoon ang support sa mga LGU officials. So mo na among ginahimo karon para ma-improve ang living conditions sa ato mga mangingisda diri sa atong nasod.
Okay, thank you, Sec. Okay, na to, sir. Okay, thank you. Our next question will come from our intern from Philippine News Agency. Please state your name and school.
Hi, Benedict. PNA intern from USDP. Sir, ang target ninyo for 21.6% na rate of poverty kay to 14%.
14%.
Yes, so in terms of other sectors, just like women, children, youth, and students, unsa ang agenda ang inyong ginabuhat? And then, how can we maintain this all throughout the years?
Okay. Mabitaw na ang kanindot sa struktura karon sa NAPC. Nga ang balaod nga nagmugna sa NAPC, iya nang yung gibutang ang 14 basic sectors nga partner yun sa atong gobyerno. No? So, doon ay 14 basic sectors, katong akong ipangbasa ganiha, o doon na po 14 line agencies nga iyang partner. Sa balaod na so, unsay tumong, ana, para ang ato mga 14 basic sectors makaparticipate na sa decision making processes sa atong gobyerno, no? Nga dili na lang sila magyaw-yaw-yaw-yaw, dili na lang sila mo rally-rally dito sa kalsada, no? Kundi maglingkod na gyud sila sa usa ka lugar nga kauban na nila ang mga opisyales sa 14 line agencies. So, doon na tayo ginatawag nga in-bank session sa NAPC. The in-bank is presided by the president himself, no, as the chairman of the NAPC. O naapod ang 14 basic sectors dito o ang mga secretaries and undersecretaries sa itong mga line agencies. Dito mismo, istoryahan na unsa ang mga issues and concerns sa mga 14 basic sectors o tubagon dayon sa atong mga secretaries and undersecretaries sa atong line agencies. No? Muna ang kanindot sa struktura sa NAPC nga what dili na nimo makita sa other government agencies. So, for example, sa women, naa sila'y problema sa kining sa maternity leave, di ba? Ang women sector na hangyo ana nga kinahanglan mabag-o ang balaod kaysa karon mura pila lang gamay ra kayo 60 days lang man siguro, no? Ang hangyo sa mga women nga pataasan ang panahon nga doon na sila yung maternity leave. So doon na ay balaod, no, nga kung wala ko nagsayo, ready for the signature or tingali nakapasa na yun, ready for the signature of the president nga ang maternity leave mo una mga 120 days, di ba? So mo ito, ang resolution immediate kay nakita naman ang basic sectors o ang line agencies. No? So, among tumong ana nga katong problema sa atong basic sectors, doon ay immediate action, either ang action himuon nga balaod or himuong programa or polisiya sa line agencies. Mao na.
Okay, thank you. Okay na to siya, Benedict. Alright, so, kinsa pa ilaing mga tana? From... Wala. Mag-live daw siya. Maybe UNTV, ha? Huh? Sorry, Rajanio 1, sorry.
Sir, isa sa kanisa. Kaninsa, Lanao del Sur, yes. Part ni ang Marawi City, which is ni Marawi City, mm-hmm. Ngayon ito po. unsay mga interventions nga binagid karon kay hangtod karon na kapaghihapon ng mga IDPs sagaran sa evacuation center. Unsay pa sabay mga interventions nga atong matabang pud gikan sa national nga sa directly nato sa mga affected to.
Sa NAPC, dunay usa sa sektor katong victims of disasters and calamities. Kini aktibo kayo ni sila og apil diha to mga victims of Marawi siege. Daghan kayo silang mga resolutions nga gipagawas na og ako as the lead convener secretary of NAPC, ako na pong gipa-refer dito sa task force Bangon Marawi. Og ang among nakita diha very receptive ning task force nga kini mga problema karon sa ato mga IDPs, no? Tagaan yun nila go action. Among role particularly kay bago ra man ko sa NAPC yun, no? I assume office last November 12 ra. Ako pang ihangyoon ang task force Bangon nga ang NAPC mismo maka-appeal sa mga meetings, mga dialogues and conferences para na po pitbito na namo itong among sektor. No, mismo dito na sa meeting mismo madungog na mismo sa members of the task force na mauni ang problema o kinahanglan immediate action among the task force members. Wala ang among ginahimo karon o himuon pa para sa atong mga IDPs diha sa Marawi.
Pero sir, kanang murag 2 years naman ang nahitabo noon diha sa Marawi. Dapat tayo monitoring like ni murag elevate na bang ilang hintang karon nga kalisod from the moment nga nahitabo to hangtod kay 2 years naman ang nilabay.
Well, of course, no, ang akong nahibaw-an doon na ay mga provision sa ilang housing. Pero akong pagtuo, doon na pagyot kakulangan. Una-una, ang among orientasyon sa NAPC is kinahanglan, appeal kyot ang katauhan sa pagdesisyon. No? Mauna ang gusto na mo nga dag-on dito sa Task Force Bangon Marawi. Nga dili lang mga government agencies, officials ang nag-istorya-istorya, kundi mismo sa pag-istorya o resolution sa problema, naana dayon ang mga biktima. So, among dalaman sa NAPC, kining among bias nga community organizing, maungin ang among dadundiha o community development. No? So, unsa man na, kung ang problema sa IDPs ang panimalay paghihapon, so kinahanglan to bago na sa NHA. Diba? Pero so para, in fairness, sa among pagtanaw, mas responsive ang tubag sa atong gobyerno karon diya sa Marawi compared to Yolanda typhoon Yolanda areas, no? Nga compare nimo ang balay sa mga biktima ni Yolanda kung ang balay sa mga biktima sa Marawi dili gud pareho, no? Murag ang dito sa Yolanda murag kaluoy kayo ang gigamit ng mga materials sab standard. Pero diri in so far, in fairness sa akong observation, diri sa Marawi, no, walay problema ang materials gigamit sa atong mga temporary shelter sa atong mga biktima, no. Pero of course may kakulangan pa na kinahanglan yun punan dayon, no. Immediately dapat immediate action ang himuon diha kay para kumudugay mag-create man ang problema, no? Ang instruction ni President Duterte nga panaugan niyo dapat og serbisyo ang mga katawhan. So mao na dapat ang himuon na mo sa gobyerno, no? No?
Dapat last.
Okay, sir, kanang nagmark as red po kining probinsya sa Bukidnon. Dili sa NMR. Unsa bay mga recommendations na lang nato ngadto sa ato sa LGU sa probinsya kay sila mong itong direkta no nga naa din 24/7. Unsa man itong mga recommendation para mo dili na nimo red sa sunod nga mga tuig-an.
Oh. Usa sa among recommendation diha nga i-institutionalize gyud tong people's participation, no? Or kanang ginatawag natong governance nga appeal gyud ang katawhan, no? Kay syempre kung ang mga official lang ang mo decide pero dili di ay haom sa kinahanglan sa katawhan, mao na ang dakong problema. So nakita naman nato nga dunay kapobrehon ang usa ka lugar. So unsay kinahanglan? Muhimo og mga una i-identify kinsa gyud tong pobre sa lugar. Ang NAPC dunay mi usa ka tool nga pwede namong i-commit sa LGU katong among ginatawag nga rapid community-based monitoring system nga kung asa real-time, faster, and credible collection of data per household good by just using your mobile phones. Wala na yung papel-papel. Ang among mga tawag niya, field evaluators or enumerators, trained enumerators na mo, no, paadto na mo diya sa usa ka barangay, magsuroy sila dito, no, sa per household, mangutana sa mga data, for example, pila sila nga membro sa usa ka pamilya, unsa ang ilang pagkakitaan, unsa naman ang edad sa ilang mga anak, o pila ang ilang anak, no, unsa ba nagutom ba sila or wala, no? Kana immediately by using your phone, no, ang data makolekta na dayon dito sa amo sa Manila sa among server. So kini importante ni kay para makahimo gyud ta og accurate nga planning o kung duna kay planning para ma-implement ana, doon na yun tayo dapat nga budget. Diba? So, makatabang yun na sa ilang tinuoray nga planning and budgeting para pagtubag dito sa kapobrehon sa ilang lugar. Ana?
Okay, person?
Okay, last two question lang.
I have a last two question. Medyo, ipin ko kayo satisfied no, sa kining how you strategize the poverty alleviation on the poorest 40-10-10 areas. So, check in yung best strategy to address poverty incidents on these 40-10-10 areas.
Sige. Ang una yun na, ipakita na namo ganyan, no? For 2019, kini 40 riyay, mao ni ang pinakapubre nga probinsya. Tapos 10 pinakapubre nga munisipyo. Tapos 10 na pinakapubre nga barangay sa kana nga munisipyo. So, we already identified these provinces, municipalities, and barangays through the Philippine Statistics Authority. No? Na kini mga lugar nga pobre kayo. So that 40-10-10 is our target. So part of our social preparation is our coordination with the elected officials of that province. No? Mag-coordinate me, then we'll tell them na according to PSA, your province is one of the poorest provinces in the Philippines. Basakitan man sila or no, pero mao mang ginang tinuod So we coordinate with them. And then, of course, pangutan mo na mo, kung sa may kinahanglan nga tabang, usually, ang mga gobernador, musulti nga na, ang kinahanglan na mo o pondo para sa among kalsada, pondo para sa among mga infrastructure projects, di ba? Pero okay lang kung na, kaya ang mga infra, no, will also lead to poverty reduction. Pero kinahanglan is ihimuan na to o maayong plano, no? Nga mag-interconnect. For example, kung doon na na-survey ang usa ka probinsya, nga na-identify na nila asa itong mga kapubrigyo kaayong nga tao sa ilang probinsya, so magsukod na sa pag-imo o plano o pag-budget diha. Karon ang among sugyot diha, identify naman nato ang atong mga pobre nga tao, we need to organize them. Diba? Organize naman sila. Kaya para makauban sila sa atong pag-istorya, para makauban po sila sa atong mga desisyon. Diba? So, sa umpisa pa lang, kuyog na sila, they own already the solutions to their problems. Tanaw na ko, dili na kayo lisod magsunod sa ilang komunidad. Diba? Kung wala pa'y data, that's the time that NAPC will offer our services. No? Yung ginatawagan nila mong community, rapid community monitoring system na akong gisaysay na ganiha. Then, after that, doon na na'y data, real data, we begin planning and we find money to execute all our plans. Diba? So, kauban na diha, livelihood, kung problema gyud nga education, we call the Department of Education. Diba? Kung problema ang walay skills ang mga tao, we call the TESDA. Diba? Hmm. Problema nila, wala sila seats para mag tanom, we call the Department of Agriculture. Diba? Oh. So kung mangingisda, we call the BIPAR. Problema nila ilang panglawas. Diba? Ang ilang health. We call on the Department of Health. My point here is, dili lang NAPSI ang muhatag og solusyon, but it's the whole government using the whole of government approach. Pagkahuman niya, of course, gobyerno, doon na pa may laing sektor. We need to ask the participation of the business sectors or the civil society. No? So, appeal, tanan sa pag-hisgot o pagplano o pag-implement sa proyekto. So, that's the concept of whole of society approach. Diba? Kana, ang mga atong himuon diha. In a way, open ang governance, open ang tao nga maka-participate. In a way, makita na to nga atong yun ma-eradicate or malesen ang ginatawag na itong corruption. And of course, ang atong presidente, doon ang yun usaka political will, ingon niya, kung na-corruption niya, ina ko kay ako ng tagaan solusyon. O nakita na yun na ito atong presidente nga sincere yun sa pag-sumpo, no? Paghunong pinang corruption sa atong gobyerno. Kaya na, sir, mauna ang among plano niya.
Pero sir, naisgutan maging mo, no, ang best system on deterring poverty incidents sa community through rapid community-based monitoring system using the technology, mobile phones. Now, unsay difference ani sa listahan concept ng DSWD?
Ang difference ani, wala na may papel. Wala na may papel. Dili na ka paperless ni. Paperless of real time. Immediately pagtuplok nimo sa imong cellphone, ang data makuha na dayon sa among server o mo-process na dito o ato nang i-print. Mauna ka, paspas. Wala. Ang listahanan, I know, papel-papel pa na, di ba?
Yeah.
Oh, so kung papel-papel, ano pa manani mo? Gather ni mong papel, then ipo mo nang i-type, imo ipadala. So it will take time. Pero here, sa amo, this is faster and reliable. Mga difference, sir?
May possibility na BSWD will pattern your concept?
Well, we are introducing this system to DSWD. No? Ang si Secretary Rolando Bautista, no? Usa siya ka tawo nga kumakita yun niya nga nindot, iyan yun ang i-adapt. So hoping nga tanan kining atong gobyerno ba maghimo og usa ka sistema nga paspas og reliable og credible. So kung this is the system credible, reliable and faster sa NAPC, so kung duna pa mas faster ilaha dito pud ni. Pero kung kining past amo ang faster, kinahanglan na di ba mag tinabangay para sa ang bottom line lang there is for us to help our poor people, no, to uplift the living condition of our poor people nga maka tagamtam po sila o benepisyo o kahayahay sa ilang kinabuhi, di ba?
Just to add to what Secretary Nolan said, no? We are innovating and introducing the concept of the practice of the vulnerability risk assessment in our RCPMS system. No, gusto naming one of Secretary Noel's flagship advocacy is climate change adaptation. So we are introducing the BRA into the RCPMS in order ultimately to help the poor communities deal with climate change by formulating their own local climate change action plan, so that these poor and vulnerable communities will be able to tap fund sources like the People's Survival Fund and ultimately this newly opened Green Climate Fund internationally.
Okay, thank you po. Next question, sir.
Yes, sir. Talking about innovation in regards to the DSWD program, concerned about the Poor Peace Program, sir, is there any strategy by the NAPC to see to it that the proper disposition of that assistance will be properly used by the beneficiaries?
Yeah. We already talked to Secretary Bautista about that, and he is amenable for NAPC to help in the organization of the Poor Peace and also in the disbursement of the Sustainable Livelihood Fund. So, ginaayos pa lang namo ang among mga guidelines, no? So in due time makahibalo na kita kung unsay maayo gyud para sa atong mga poor peace, no? The concept of poor peace is noble kasi ano ni, social protection, pero of course in the implementation process doon ang yun mga nagsimang-simang. So, nangayon lupos. So, mga itong, kung naay leakage niya, atong tapakan ng leakage para wala na problema. Kana.
Okay,
Yes, sir. Thank you. Follow-up question. One more question, sir. NAPC does only concerns with deterrence of poverty, and one main cause of poverty is unemployment. Do you consider linking up with only about unemployment, sir?
As I said before, our approach here is convergence. So, if the problem is about employment, we invite DOLE. In fact, we encourage more workers in the labor and informal labor sector to really organize themselves, because there are funds available for the organized labor. No? So, doon na may ginahimo anak, no? Convergence, good. We bring all the line agencies in one area for the people to directly receive the services. So, during our kining among ginanot, karaban man ang among tawag, no? Kung magkaraban, may naa ang taga-dole. So, ilang, sana, job, tawag nila diya? Job fairs, di ba? Oo. So, dala na nila.
Just to stress, no? As you will know, the NAPC under the leadership of Secretary Noel Felongco will be a new NAPC. Okay? This is the NAPC that will attempt to bring down the services or policies down to the poorest sectors of our society. It is a NAPC that will be as proactive as much as possible, because Sec. Noel and President Duterte are proactive leaders themselves. The PCB mechanism he mentioned earlier will be an attempt to bring NAPC down to the provincial level and ultimately down to the barangay level. After all, the target is at least 6 million by year 2022. And NAPC won't be able to do that if it sticks to its business as usual mandates. NAPC will be proactive this time, and we are on the way to becoming that. Thank you.
Okay, thank you po. Yes po, may additional one. Okay, any other questions from our press members here? May mga ladies, isa lang, sige. Okay, from Brigada Citizen.
Yeah, muna-unaan
ba po? Karoon po ka muna-unaan lang, muna po kong report. Sir, nana ko ipakutan na, sir, regarding sa NAPC, kung sa'yo gibasihan, sir, para makaingunta na, kana nga lugar, wala na siya nalakip sa gi-consider nga nag-antos nga lugar. Kung sa'yo pasihan, yeah, sa barangay ba, every municipio, or ang LGUK mismo?
Yeah. Ang gibasihan na, katong ato pagyod nga PSA, Philippine Statistics Administration or Authority, no? Nga og NEDA, nga ilang gi tan-aw unsa ang poverty incidence sa usa ka lugar. Oh, tapos doon na sila yung percentage nga gihatag. Oh, muna. Oh. So, for example, sa Lanao Sur, ako tanaw, sakto man po, di ba? Nga, ang Lanao Sur ang number one good nga pobre nga area sa Pilipinas. If you go to Lanao Sur, makita mo yun mo ang kahimtang. Muna ang basihanan. Tamo.
So, usan na ng mga structures, mga businesses mo na ginagtaw ko?
Ang sa PSA is the income. Income and expenditure sa mga katawhan. Pila ba ang income sa bawat individual? diha sa usa ka lugar. Diba?
What do you be looking forward, sir, to examples or dili sa kagayati oro? Klaro magid kayo nga panahon sa eleksyon ang mga politiko moabot yung pinakatumoy nga barangay nga dili nila gusto at kuhan. At then ayaw pa nila mahatag ang mga needs sa mga tao, pero kung wala taong lugar sa kinatibukan, they need help.
Yes.
Ma-consider ka na sila nga ma-appeal sila sa ihap atong giingon nga nasa poverty nga level?
Oh, naihap yun na. Naihap yun na sila, no? Nga kanang mga unserved and underserved nga katawhan, naihap yun na sila nga sila yun ang pinaka-pobre.
Are you looking forward, sir, nga pinagi sa NAPC? Kamus mismo ang himuglap kang nga inuot yun ang LGU nga abutong yun ang lagyo nga barangay direct ba ng seleksyon?
Yes, mao kinang among tumong nga dili lang panahon sa eleksyon at tuon ka ng mga tao na, no? Kay sila, Pilipino man po na sila. Tapos ang atong mahal na presidente ni Sulte Bea, yun na, I want you to gain back the trust of the people. So kung saan ang pagbalik o trust katawhan, at tuon yun sa gobyerno, dili ang katawhan ang mo adto sa gobyerno, no? So mo na lang among ginahimo karon nga do na may sambayanihan, serbisyong sambayanan, no? Nga ang if yun is adtoon yun tanan nga mga line agencies, diba? Wadto sa usa ka lugar para direkta nga muhatag og serbisyo ana. Then amo pagipunan kay para ang katawhan makaparticipate yon sa provincial level, mao tong among provincial consultative assemblies or bodies nga naa ang 14 basic sectors o naa po tong 14 line agencies. Mag-istorya. Tapos immediately tagaan o aksyon ang ilang mga problema. Katawhan mismo ang magsulti. Wala may tubig sa among komunidad. MWSS. Oh, unsa man ang imong matanaw? Oh, water district. Unsa man? Mayor, unsa man imong makatubag? Itubag dere. Mao na among tumong.
Okay, thank you, Secretary. Any other questions or follow-up?
Last na lang gid
na.
Okay, sige.
It's about the ALG Saling Tubig program. Doon na ba yung na-identify na sa... It's a identification is Region 10. Nga pila ka areas nga huwag pag panubig.
Sorry, good on. Wala ko'y concrete nga tubag, anak. Kay wala ko'y data pag yun sa Region 10. Diba? So... Ang importante dere nga ang NAPC appeal sa kini nga saling tubig, pero ang lead agency ani gyud ang DILG. Ana.
Okay, thank you, sir. So okay na ang talan. So naklaro na sa talan. Okay, before siguro ta mag-closing kayo, sir, nakapunta na. Sir, would NAPC, will we see NAPC more often dere sa Region 10?
Yeah, that's the reason.
Yes.
Yes,
una wala kyo. Mao na ng among purpose diri nga nganong gihimo namo ang among strategic planning o team building diri sa Cagindi Oro, no? Kay gusto namo nga maatuan po ang mga lugar nga wala kahibalo na duna diay NAPC. Di ba? Oh, kay ang basically ang NAPC is only a Manila based agency. But it's a national agency having the office only in Manila. So Manila-centered pa siya. Karon, we are experimenting na as much possible, ang presence sa NAPC will be felt by the people of Mindanao. So we already set up a satellite parang tawag diya, not really the real office, pero doon na ng mga tao, no? Hopefully, ang DSWD will give a space in their regional offices. So kung doon na may mga tao nga every time, kung doon ay meeting ang mga basic sectors, maka-appeal yun ang NAPC. Kana so rest assured, permita magkita din sa Region 10.
What year the net was created?
1998. Lugay na yun.
Nandiyan
okay, thank you so much, Secretary. So I guess okay na, no? Okay na tong mga media personnel here with our press con. So now let's give the floor to our panelists for their closing statements.
Yeah. So just want to reiterate our banner programs, and we truly believe that these programs will bring NAPC much closer to the people. No? So I mentioned these programs already, but please allow me to reiterate. The programs are the Sambayanihan, Servisyong Sambayanan or SSS, then the Provincial Consultative Body, and then the Actionable Development Agenda for Poverty Transformation or ADAPT 401010. NAPC is very much willing to assist our local government units and all stakeholders in the implementation of poverty alleviation activities, projects, and programs. So, nang hangyo ko ninyo tanan, magkuyog ta, magkahiusa ta, no? Sa kining trabaho, kay kining atong gihimo nga fight against poverty will not benefit us, but especially ang atong mga kabus nga kababayan Pilipino. So, mauna, unta ang media mutabang sa NAPC para mas mapalalong o ma-inform pa ang atong katawhan nga doon na di ay dakong programa ang atong Duterte administration to fight poverty. Dagan salamat o nga maayong buntag kaninyo tanan.
Okay, thank you so much, Secretary. Thank you so much, NAPC, for gracing this press conference. Thank you sa itong local media, CDO Media. Good day sa kanan.
I would like to invite everyone. We have a lunch. May pagkaunta dito. So, dagang salamat. Kanyang tanan.